Victory interrupted, hallelujah.
the praise of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And so God is saying, I get ready to let the church change focus. Somebody say, change your focus. Somebody say, change your focus. Hallelujah. And we hear the glory of God to lift up the mighty name of Jesus. So in the book of Mark chapter 4 and verse 35 to 44, we see where that Jesus was in the boat. Somebody say Jesus in the boat. And it's not because Jesus is on the ship that the ship won't have problem. It's not because Jesus is not in your life. Oh, Jesus is in your life, you will not touch trouble. Somebody praise his holy name. Let me take my time here. Somebody give a praise to God. Hallelujah. What white man thinks, why I love to be the ruler of life, not a slave, to lead life, hallelujah, as a powerful, hallelujah, conqueror, and nothing exterior to me will ever take command of me, glory to God. Success requires courage, hallelujah, and it requires brokenness, and to get into a place where the spiritual authority, the place of us, be rise into it. Somebody praise his mighty name. To take the dominion of anything that God brought to this post, we have to come to a conceptualization and a reorientation of the mind to step into the zone to take accessibility of the love of things that God has purposely given unto us. Somebody say, change focus. We need to understand things of God and the things of the world have been set up to captivate and to lead us into a dimension in which, hallelujah, if we're not careful, it becomes the center of our thoughts. Hallelujah. And now we do not see God's divine orchestrated plan for us. God uniquely sends design and position his people in the return to arrive or to come to a place where we can insert ourselves to his original divine plan and purposes, and whatever he say, we will have. Somebody shout hallelujah. We spoke about faith last week. Hallelujah. We need to use our faith to get us into the threshold and into the place in which God so desires to get us. Hallelujah. And we will not be fearful. We get to the point where we understand the things in which God so desires for us. Somebody praise him up in here. The Bible said in the book of St. Mark, hallelujah, the fourth chapter, that Jesus looked at the disciples and said, let us go to the other side. Somebody praise him up in here. If he said, let us go to the other side, it's the fact that they were on one side and they have exhausted the parameters, eaten all the food, drink all the drink, and all the pleasure, and they need to go to the other side because there's something more that Jesus wanted to experience. Oh, somebody say experience. And we got to change the focus. It's all of the Christian sayings of us and the people who always remember some of the past and do not want to push to go ahead. And so Jesus looked at the situation and said, I want for you all to back up the boat and to go with me to the other side. So I praise him up in here. Jesus will be full of you that going to the other side will not be easy. So I praise him up in here. Because he's always shows us the beginning and he shows us the end. But we never see the middle. I don't know why. But we don't know the struggle that we want to go. Somebody praise him. And I believe the disciples was excited. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. Because Jesus, when he came on the scene, he seen the sons of Zebedee, Peter, and all these guys that were washing their nets. He knew that they were professional fishermen, but it was the first time that all was on the right together on the boat.
And I do believe that the disciples were looking for an opportunity to ride. Somebody praise him up in here.
Somebody praise him up in here.
But although I'm your local pastor, there's a difference with you all saying you're going on a trip with Sister Audrey versus a trip with Sister Audrey and Pastor is on the bus.
Somebody even praise him. Hallelujah. There's a difference when you leave on this other trip. I gotta change my
We need to back check a little. Because if they can understand by studying the word, that even Jesus, that sell Jesus, a 1,200 pieces of silver, he didn't even want to do that. Somebody didn't praise the glory. But Judas was ideally jealous of the power of what he demonstrated. Somebody didn't praise him. And Judas was saying, if I can, I'm going to sell this power out and then politically represent it, I'm going to do what I got to do. But we got to understand that the church got a power that you is not for sale. And the church got a power you can't stop it either. The more you put the church under pressure, it's the more the church rises into its purpose. I even praise that to believe that after this closing of the church and the number 10 that is released upon the number. That's why I keep telling you to call yourself 10. Somebody praise him up in here. And somebody said, I am 10. And that's prophetic. Because if you look around right now and start counting by 10, somebody praise him up in here. Myself on the coffee being taken. Somebody praise him up in here. But since the secretary just looked around and just told Martin, somebody didn't praise him, glory. Hallelujah. You know, and write it down in your notebook. And I prophesy a little bit up in here. That by next week, this time, somebody praise him up in here. By next week, this time, Rima goes upon here to visit. Somebody praise him up in here. Is that a satisfactory number? Or we need to call in some more out of it. Somebody give him praise and glory up in here. Somebody say, by faith.
By faith.
I'm 10.
I'm 10.
By faith.
By faith.
I'm gonna be blessed.
I'm gonna be blessed.
By faith.
Somebody didn't praise the glory. The same computers up in here. The same computer that used to research to create vaccines, and the same thing they learned how to.
Somebody praise the name. It's the same vaccines. And after a while, what the Lord showed me this morning is that the same vaccines, because the way God arranged it came over and to strike Bill Gates, no vaccination ain't gonna happen. Somebody give praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because they're gonna come with the same something that will inject over what he creates. Somebody give him praise the Lord.
Some batteries for this one. This, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yourselves.
Hallelujah. Can we continue to preach? The Bible said that the disciples go to the other side. Going to the other side, focusing on the other side was like being a pleasure trip. And making the boys, they believe that they were on vacation. And the Bible said that they going to the other side, the wind became boisterous. And in other words, the wind stopped blowing heavily. Somebody praise him up in here. In other words, the wind was blowing seriously, determinedly. One to capsize their boats, and they were not sure anymore. They were in the middle of the boat, somebody said, middle of the sea. They were not, hallelujah, not sure anymore that they were closer to the other side. But the wind decided to start blowing. Not only did the wind blow, the water came into the boat, and they looked like it was about to sink. And right in the middle of the pandemic, they looked like they were.
Because the Bible never said in the noise, it said in his presence. preach by disobedience. He may not be in my job, because the company I work for, the boss there launched it deep in the trap. But he said, I am no friend, not sticking closer than a brother. I mean, wherever I go, he goes. And if I'm at the job, he's here with me. Can I tell you that's why they can't fire you? Because there's something about you. It's not all the hell they're trying. When you get to work, you really get to work.
Can I preach like this? There's something on you because of his presence. There's a grace on you. Somebody say grace. That they're really trying to get rid of you, but they can't. They're lying to you, but they still gotta watch you. Somebody praise him up in here. They know that there's something about you that they hate, but there's more about you that they got to love. I don't know what preaching to right now. They want to see you back, but they can't read it. Because they're looking at the right eye that you do not need to come to work. But they're looking at you too to see you come to the door. Somebody praise him up in here. There's something about you when you walk in the room.
Yes.
In spite of who that was in there before, your presence counts. Somebody said presence.
Yes.
I know the preachers are waiting for me. Somebody praise from me. Yes. Somebody praise from me. Somebody praise from me. Somebody said presence.
Yes.
And so the water came in the boat. And Peter was worrying about the water in the boat. But the water in the boat with the hand. The water in the boat represents the Holy Spirit. Somebody give me praise and glory. Because water goes to the Spirit. Somebody says Spirit. And God was going outside. His voice was on the outside. But when the water came on the inside, because Jesus is on the boat, the water automatically changed. So Peter believed that the water was there to drown them. But the water was just there to refresh them.
Yeah,
Can somebody change focus, change focus? If I watch the storm, the lightning where I'm supposed to get, I guess I'm blessing again so that I can press the door. You see, because sister, there is something on the other side. And Jesus would not decide to go over if there was not something to go for. And I want to focus on it. Can somebody focus? Yes. Because you can't watch the distraction. But the distraction is embedded to bring destruction. The distraction is embedded to bring paranoia. The distraction is intended to bring disease. The distraction is intended to bring disaster. Somebody even brings a glory like me. The distraction is intended to bring disturbance. But I have to focus. Why? Jesus sent them before, and he came at midnight, but this time he was with them.
You see, there's a difference when he sends you than when he's with you.
Somebody praise God and pray. You see, when he sends me, I'm a little bit timid. And I gotta work my faith up, even in a greater way than when he's with me. But he's on the boat is different from when he sent the boat ahead and decided to catch up later. Somebody was worshiping. And that's why, while he was on the boat, he went to sleep. Somebody praise him up in here. Because we serve a God that is not easily disturbed. And is not easily perturbed. I really want to get to that place. Somebody praise him up in here. Where nothing more bad than it ended, but there will be nothing bad than you. Because if you really got faith, nothing will really bother you. Somebody praise him. Can I tell you that what you're going through right now is just your perception, your perception. It's just a perception, a perception. And the scripture is talking about the perception. It's talking about the plan. And it's talking about the promise. Can I preach to many people? If the devil can let you have a wrong perception about the thing, you will have it.
Just hear what Peter, hear the wrong perception. Can I bring it up on the text?
Said, Master, thou carest if we perish. In other words, you take us from where we were safe. Decide to take us where we are not safe. To a place where we don't even know where we're going. And then you fall asleep. Somebody say perception. And a lot of times, church folk have a wrong perception. Because we see vaguely. And the Bible says we see in part because we know in part. When Jesus said we were going to the other side, he knew that there was going to be a storm. But he knows that we've got to take great faith to get you to the next level. Somebody even praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because God Almighty. Come here, my sister. Come here, my sister. Somebody did not praise the Lord. Somebody worship God. And stand over here. Stand right there. And she stand there. Church, look at these two young ladies. Aren't they beautiful? And they have gone to school and they've qualified themselves. So they are professionals. Somebody say professionals. It's a day and age that that they teach the church, that after they reach to this stage, they go to school, get their education, and they're saved. The next thing the church got them through is what?
Come
on. I like it. You're following carefully. So everybody is trying to induct marriage into their head. I want to give them a man, somebody in the presence of Lord. But nobody is trying to teach them how to live with what they're giving them. Because what they're giving them are problems. And they say marriage are teeth.
Come on, let me explain somebody, praise God.
But they're looking good now, mighty Father. And after they acquire what the church wants to give them, because that's where the church is cultured. And when they start going to this struggle, the church back out. Somebody did not praise the Lord, hallelujah. And when the church starts pointing the finger at who is right and who is wrong, somebody don't like what I'm saying up in here, but I'm coming to you, somebody praise the Lord, hallelujah. You see, it's good to tell them that they need to get married, but somebody needs to teach them how to live while they're in it. Somebody praise the Lord, hallelujah. Somebody praise him up in there, hallelujah. While you were telling them about marriage, they see the cup, they see the cake, they see the diet party, and they see the wedding day, somebody in the praise of glory. They see the coming home, they see the marriage water, and they see the things in which they're supposed to have. They see the ring with a lot of diamonds, and they see the lot of pearls, and they see the congregation coming in, and they hear the song, here comes a bride. They hear the very part, the wedding part, they hear. And they say it with a mouth. But after tomorrow, after the Holy Moon, here comes all type of stuff that happened. Somebody praise God up in here, hallelujah. Oh, I'm not gonna live with it for 10 years. Oh, I'm not gonna live with it for 20 years. Oh, I'm not gonna live with it for 30 years. Oh, I'm not gonna live with it for 1 year. Here comes your back to get Jesus. Somebody give it praise and glory, hallelujah. This magnet was not in it in the first place. But oh, glory to God, hallelujah. You're not just needing in it, you're needing for it, you're needing over it, and you're needing on it. Somebody praise him in the shoe. What am I trying to say here? Is that that what did you probably promise? Oh, I did. I said to get you to the next time, in the next place. Because I'm sure these are only that as my mother said, eating salt, and they will definitely like your thirst to be quenched.
Somebody say perception.
start to read the scriptures, I do believe that COVID and whatever is presently happening coming to bring the body of Christ to a place that we have never gone to. You may not agree with me. Amen. Come on, somebody up here. But I believe the saints have been tested and tried to come to the place in which we have never used our faith before, or to exercise the authority that God has given among to us. Because on a regular day, the church would be packed up, and people would come and receive the praise of worship song, and they pray an intercessory prayer, and then we agree the confession of the statement and the church statement. We think of the dead sides of our prayer, the preacher puts the word, amen, and then the benediction is being pronounced. There was someone up here. And people used to call that church, and when it comes to time, they want one type of day. They have sold 5,000 in the ministry and tell the pastor, don't let nobody announce me. Somebody will praise the Lord. They don't need a public announcement. They're about the church of the system. I mean, if you see me Sunday morning, somebody praise God. Hallelujah. I was in the first session. I was at the door. And a gentleman drove up to the bus and said, is Crystal at church? I said, yes, Crystal is in there. And then going to God, I talked to Sister Crystal. He gave me a remote mic and a plug-in section. And it's one of the most expensive mics, sure remote mics on the Lord. He said, bring it to Sister Crystal. I was not feeling happy already, so I'm going to praise the Lord. Because I need this Sister Crystal. So I walked up to her and I said, Sister Crystal, thank you for buying me a sure mic. So I need my praise the Lord. But she said she never acts surprised. She said, not yet, but one day. Or you're still. So I need my praise the Lord. I like the thing behind me, so I need my praise. Because a sure mic like that in Jamaica, maybe it probably about $50,000 to $60,000. But she didn't laugh and say, oh, I have no money. She said, not yet. Somebody say, not yet. I believe that God's going to bless somebody. Hallelujah. So my faith, I already opened my mouth and prepared her in the atmosphere that she's going by and she will not tell me to praise the Lord. And she did not say it ain't going to happen. She said, not yet, but somebody believe and praise the Lord. I still believe that one of these things is going to happen. I believe that God's going to bless somebody, somebody to praise the Lord. So the Bible said that Jesus said to the disciples, oh, I can learn anything since you're around here. I can learn to exercise your faith. I can see you lay hands on the sick of the silver color. I can see you lay hands on the blind. And the blind you see, I speak on death here. Somebody give me praise and glory. I can see I walked on the sea before. And I'm with you now, hallelujah. And I'm already in the boat and I'm fretting about it. Somebody praise him up in here. Oh, Jesus is still in the church. The problem that people